الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم لك استشهد في يوم الجمعة. The wild mushrooms. And first of all, I'd like to thank Mrs. Basma Bint Ali for the great encouragement, for the unlimited support, as well as for sharing us in collecting mushroom samples. We keep our samples in tightly closed glass jars in formaldehyde solution for the museum. And our objectives is to establish a checklist of the wild mushrooms of Jordan as a part of the National Species Database, to establish the National Museum of Wild Mushrooms of Jordan at the Royal Botanic Garden at Tel Roman, as well as to produce a book field guide for the poisonous as well as for the edible mushrooms, and also to establish an online gallery about the wild mushrooms of Jordan. The nutritional value of the mushroom, if we eat 100 gram of mushroom, this should be enough for the daily body requirements. It is rich with vitamins as well as with the protein, essential amino acids and minerals. So the mushrooms are a good source of vitamins B1, B2, B3 as well as B5 and B6. Also the essential amino acids as well as the protein. It is rich with the protein, around 20 to 30% of the dry weight percentage containing protein. It's also a good source of minerals as phosphorus, magnesium, potassium, and selenium. We know selenium is an antioxidant compound. Also, it contains no fat, so it is a diet for the people suffering from cholesterol. And it is again low in sodium. Mushroom is also a good source of fiber, and it's also an antioxidant. It helps in cancer treatment, and at last, it is also a good food for the people who are suffering from heavy weight, and it contains less calorie, less energy, but it's also an anti-aging material. What is a mushroom? Mushroom is normally the fruiting structure of the fungus, where it carries the spores under the cap or on the gills, which normally either could be carried in the naked form on the basidium, or could be in the pouch or on the closed, tightly closed fruiting structures, including the acai as the ascospores. The mushroom normally it should grow either on the soil, or to have an organic matter to it never grow in the stone or grow in the air. But of course, we have the detrimental or the harmful fungi, which are completely different from mushrooms. These are called around microscopic mushrooms and fungi, but mushrooms, they are macroscopic. We can see them by the naked eye. Most mushrooms are edible and highly delicious. Others are not edible, and some of them are deadly or poisonous. It's an example of the poisonous mushrooms. On the right side is an edible mushroom. So the function of the mushroom is the fruiting structure to produce the spores for the propagation, as well as for the having the next season. Spore identification is very important, and it's the master key for the mushroom classification. We should look for the spore shape, for the spore color. We may have some spore prints here on the right side. It is the spore print of Mycena, which it has white spores. On the left side, basidium spores of Agaricus, which has a bean shape, as well as it is red under microscope, but it has black spore print. Groups of mushroom, they belong to two different groups, ASCO mycota, which includes the morels, cup fungi, and truffles. So they produce their spores in the closed ascus, the fruiting structure, and the spores are born in the asci, where the spores normally come from this asci upon the maturity. They are called as spore shooters, because they shoot spores from these sacs. The cup fungi is one of these examples where the asci they are formed on the inner wall of these cup-shaped mushrooms. Whether it is not edible or maybe poisonous. The second group is Parasito mycota, which includes the agaric bolets as well as the polypores. They bear their spores in the gills in the basidium, and they are naked, so they drop normally after they mature, and they are called as spore droppers. An example of the Parasito mycota, the agaric on the left, and on the right is the jelly fungi. It looks like a gel growing on the soil surface. It has green. We may find other things or other species which has yellow. We'll see. So the mushrooms most people recognize are the gilt fungi. They call these are mushrooms, but they did not agree on the other types of mushrooms. We will see that the mushrooms, which it has also medicinal value, or could be beneficial for the animals in the wild, could be also mushrooms which has the same value as well as for the human beings, the edible ones. Such a mushroom grows on the wood branches or on the tree stumps. They have medicinal value more than the nutritional value for human beings. Are these mushrooms? Yes. They have different shapes, looks like a buff ball, and upon maturity, these spores come from the opening at each or any side of the balls. Gilt mushrooms, which people normally agree that these are mushrooms, they have either ring on the right side, this is a leputa, and on the left side, lepista, which has no rings. Can see the nice gill where the spores are formed on the on this surface. This is the underside surface of the mushroom. The pore fungi are similar in appearance, but have a spongy layer of tubes of pores on the underside of the cap instead of gills. These are mushrooms of pores instead of gills. By the way, we found this sample on Sunday. The last Sunday, it's a woody fungus which also formed on the tree trunk, could be detrimental for the tree. There's also a pore mushroom, this obelitis, could be also eaten, that contain high sulfur compounds. So mushroom collection requires simple equipment, but it is a tedious work and time consuming. Should look for the forest, you should look everywhere to find the mushroom, maybe under a stone, maybe under the soil. We must dig everywhere to find the mushroom, especially in our dry climate. Here our team collecting wild mushrooms, but Princess Basmati started collecting mushrooms 1 year ago, where she sent to us our lab the first two samples, and we will see the shape of these samples. This is our lab and office, full with equipment, materials, and boxes. So it's very important to note in the field to record where the mushroom is growing, whether it is on the wood or on the soil or on moss, or could be on other mushroom. It's very important also to write where it grows and whether it grows singly or in clusters, as well as the other data concerning the color of the cap, of the gill, as well as the stem. And this will help in the lab for the further identification. To date, I have found in this study until now 55 different species, which belongs to 33 different genera, but we expect to have more and more. We are just in the beginning of the season. We have more than 75 until now preserved samples and formaldehyde solution, which are under identification. We have plenty of samples, especially when President Basmat Ali shared us in collecting mushrooms. The Agaricus, which is the most important genus, we have found 12 different species from Litosepa to Cuprinus, 4 species. Inosepa, which mostly they are poisonous, around 5 species, and Epirotus, which is totally edible. And our national Tanaromban mushroom is one of them. And the Trichoroma, which is a mycorrhizal mushroom, we'll see. Now, this is one of the, our Rasobucon lichulus. It is not edible. It is found in the Arjuna and Sakib area, which is rich in wild mushrooms. And it is embedded in the soil. You can see it looks like a potato. These are not potato tubers. These are mushrooms. Also, Piziza ripanda, it is not edible. It has a ball shape. Once it's mature, it will explode. Also, it looks like a cup shape. Piziza sacosa, it's not edible. The different 12 Agaricus species, where most of them are edible, we'll see. Agaricus altipus, it is edible. Even in summertime, it could be found in the lawns or in the wet or irrigated fields. Agaricus bernardi, we call it as salt mushroom, and we hope to produce this in indoor. It is edible and it has large size and good taste. Agaricus biosporus, it's a wild isolate, let us see, from what we can see in the supermarket. And Agaricus mesaveniens is not edible or should be avoided. Campestris is one of the excellent and the delicious mushrooms. It's found in Al Mu'ammariya and has large size and good taste. Agaricus biosporus, it's a wild isolate, let us see, from what we can see in the supermarket. And Agaricus mesaveniens is not edible or should be avoided. Campestris is one of the excellent and the delicious mushrooms. It's found in Al Mu'ammariya and in Al Zarqa during August. In one of the nurseries. Agaricus excellens was found at the University of Jordan. It's edible also. Lanipas, it is not edible and should be avoided. Agaricus litoralis, an edible one. You can see the ring on the stem or on the spike with the dark chocolate brown gills. This is Agaricus micromegathus, it is edible and delicious. Could be also found in summer or in fall time in lawns. This is one of the poisonous Agaricus species, Agaricus blachomyces. And porphyrazine also, it is poisonous. It has scales on the upper cap surface. Porphyrocephalus, also one of the poisonous Agaricus mushrooms, should be also avoided. It was found again in August, in the hottest part of the year, in Al Zarqa area. This is one of the porphyrongi, porphyrong mushrooms, where it's also edible. It was found in Hashemite University, in the eastern area. Calvatia sciatiformis is an edible. It was found in the RBJ and in different places in Maldiva as well as in Ramtha. It has a large size. It's also edible once it's fresh, but people are afraid from this and they use these spores really to treat wounds, mostly in the Bedouins or in the desert area, but it is edible and delicious once it looks like an eco plant fruit. may have 40, 30 centimeter size or diameter. The medicinal mushrooms is a Childostorium. It was found in Azu area during April. It grows on the tree stumps. This is one of the edible Chrysophagus mushrooms. It was found again in Sakit, which is rich in wild mushrooms. We can compare the lower surface with the upper violet upper cap surface. Clitocypa nuda is edible without alcohol. Once we drink alcohol, this will prevent the digestion of the contents of the mushroom. And the same for cuprinus, because cuprine will prevent digestion of cuprine. So I should avoid drinking alcohol with such type of wild mushroom. Clitocypa rivolosa is edible again without alcohol. Found in Tal Rumman in Marsh. Very nice and very also delicate samples. This is the first sample in this study found by President Bashar bint Ali 1 year ago. So she started collecting mushrooms with us, and great thank for Princess Basma for again sharing us and for the support and for the encouragement for this project, which without Princess Basma, it cannot see the light. Cuprinopsis lagopus, it was cuprinus or semen cuprinus. Again, it is inedible, it's very fine, very small in size. It's not toxic, but it's not edible, because it liquefies very quickly. And cuprinus disseminatus, again, is inedible. It has white cottony spots on the upper cap surface. It grows in clusters on tree stumps. Cuprinus micaceus, again, is poisonous, and it was found in Aurjan, in Azul area. Cuprinus trunculum, it grows also in clusters on tree trunks. Most of the cuprinus grows on tree stumps. It is inedible. Was found in Khilda. So we should look everywhere. We have a brochure on the website and a schedule to collect mushrooms if people can help. We appreciate them for their help in collecting mushrooms, wild mushrooms. This is again the second sample in this study found by Princess Basma bint Ali. She found more samples, and she's a good mushroom collector. Really, even the small, tiny samples that I cannot see. Again, it has 1 year old, the sample, at the same date, 12th of January, same, so it has 1 year old, the sample. The Scotus venosa, it's also poisonous, it was found in Sakin. Enteroma sapolitum, it was again found in Sakin. The last year. Fomes cementarius in salt area, it's a woody fungus, can't be eaten. And Fuligo septica was found in Suema in Gore, near the plant roots on the soil surface. Gandhiana plantum, it was found again in marsh at the west of Jordan on a pine tree's trunk. Nocipa atripus, all atripa, all Nocipa species are poisonous. It was found in Sakit, Nocipa atripus, Nocipa sinensata, was again found in Sakit, and you have the nice girl, Rupaya, the daughter of our Princess Basma bint Ali. She found this sample, really. She's sharing us more time in collecting mushrooms. Nocipa juvenile was found in Ajroun. It's also poisonous, has different color, and all were identified according to the spore shape and the spore dimensions. Nocipa hirtella was found near the Ajroun castle. It's again poisonous. Nocipa lacera also poisonous. Lichiporus sulfurus is one of the delicate and delicious mushrooms when it is fresh and when it is young. It was found on olive tree stump in Faisal Nursery in Jarash area during December this year. It will be grows as maybe as 50 centimeters in diameter as clusters growing one over each other. Nico agaricus americanus, it is edible and also found in Amman in September. It has a nice cap, upper cap, as well as a nice ring and a nice gills. Nico agaricus moissanus, it's an edible and it was found also in Al Basatin during October. Liophyllum, also it is edible, it found in Burma in marsh. Can look for the delicate gills, they are waxy gills. Marasmius epiphyllus, very small, not exceed 4 millimeter in diameter. It is also inedible, very small in size. It's worthless. It was found in Tel Roman, in our RBG. Mycena delicatilla, very, very tiny, does not exceed 3 millimeter in diameter, the cap. And again, this sample was found by Princess Vesper in Italian, most of the samples. Paniola phoenici, it's also a poisonous mushroom, very small in size, and it grows also in lawns, in irrigated fields. It was found in Al Basatin in October. And Phalaenus spini, it's also in Al Maqtas in March. Pseudonella candelinia is edible, grows in the clusters on tree stumps or on organic matter. This is one of the ball fungi. It is Sarcosphera crassa, one of the Ascomycetes mushrooms. We can see on the left side the ascospores within the outside, within the ascus, and the fruiting structure as an egg covered with soil particles. And again, this sample was found by Mrs. Basma Vinta. It was totally immersed in the soil, really. Scleroderma viricosum is an edible. It was found in December in the Ramtha area. This is one of the jelly fungi. It has an orange jelly color. Looks like a corn ear, and it was found in Jabal al-Akhdar in the bean, and it is also inedible. It was found in December and last week. Trichloma anterium, one of the delicious edible mushrooms, one of the mycorrhizal. They should grow in beneficial association with the tree roots, and it's also totally emerged or under the soil surface. Once it's come on the upper surface, soil surface, it could be contaminated with the insects. Valvarella was found in also Ramtha in December. It is delicious, edible. It has a good vulva at the base of the stipe. One of edible ball mushroom, at around 7 centimeters in diameter, Calvatia uteriformis, was found in Ajdoun in December. It has a very nice ornamentation in the upper cap surface. Liputa is also edible. It was found in Ajdoun and Ramtha last week. It has a nice vulva as well as a nice ring on the stipe with good ornamentation or good scales on the upper surface. Again, this is one of the Schizophyllum commune. These are medicinal mushrooms. They are not edible, could be medicinal. And this is the lower surface of the Schizophyllum. It has distant gills, very far from each other. This is Fetral Kalch, Rotus eryngi, which is highly delicious, edible, found in the RBG. And we hope that this mushroom will be our national RBG mushroom. It's so big, so large in size, we'll see, more than 15, 18 centimeters in diameter with a thick stem, you will see. This sample found really in December now can collect this delicious, beneficial edible mushroom. This sample was found in last year in March. You can imagine how thick the stem, how large the cap. Here the local committee collecting mushroom with us in Ajloun, and we give some of the simple gifts as t-shirts or cap for people sharing us in community mushrooms. We tried to produce or to cultivate the wild mushroom indoor. We chose three different mushrooms according to the size and according to the edibility and how they can be used, grown easily at the low economic cost. Our goal is to find the low cost and low technology methods applicable to small scale village mushroom production. How? By identification of the best nutritious wild mushrooms and producing a pure culture for these mushrooms. We produced them in our lab at the University of Jordan. Now we are producing them commercially in Spawn Association in Al Hashmi by engineer Mu'taz Basha. He covered with us in producing these spawn commercially in at the larger scale. The second goal is to identify the best growing substrates. Again, mushroom must grow in the substrate, and to identify the best growing conditions concerning the humidity as well as the best temperature. Good substrate means good mushroom growth. Of course, for any mushroom, it should pass on the three stages: the spawn running stage, the initiation or cold shock stage, and the third one is the fruiting stage, where we may raise the temperature a little bit more than in the cold shock or in the initiating or initiation stage. Some fungi are primary and some are secondary decomposers. Primary, which may grow on normal straw, but the secondary decomposers, as agaricus, it should have a fermented as well as a pasteurized compost. So, because of this, the price is very high because the cost of production is also very high. And some mushrooms are symbiotic, they live in mutualistic association with the living roots. So some fungi grow on straw, on wheat straw, normal, and on organic matter. Some grow on logs, as shiitake. And some fungi grow on standard compost, fermented and pasteurized compost, as agaricus. We must use limestone to utilize the substrate. It prefers neutral conditions around 7 pH, so we must add calcium carbonate or calcium hydroxide for the substrate before sterilization. The best temperature for mushroom growth is between 25 and 30 degrees centigrade, and you must have humid conditions between 80 to 90%. Otherwise, the mushroom will dry and will produce nothing. Substrate preparation and fermentation. For agaricus, you should have a compost according to different formula, mixing wheat straw with the manure, with some fertilizers, and with wheat bran. So, and it needs also a fermentation period more than 2 or 3 weeks in the yard of the farm. Pasteurization or killing the competitors, because again, agaricus is a secondary decomposer. The primary decomposers or the saprophytic fungi, they live on the cellulose, because these fungi will compete later in the compost. So we let the chance for these competitors to live on the cellulose, but agaricus, it live on the lignin. So by having a fermented, pasteurized compost, we have clean, no competitors to let agaricus grow and to produce. Because of this, again, it is a high price, because the cost of production is also malaria. Spawning or addition of mycelium to the substrate around 50%. And colonization will take place in 3 to 8 weeks according to the mushroom itself. For some mushrooms, the substrate needs to be cased or covered by a casing layer composed from soil and fruiting after a cold shock. Our results spawn production, we try to grow mycelium on popcorn seeds, gave a slow growth, on millet seeds, slow growth, on sorghum again, but the best was wheat seeds, and we must not agitate or shake the jars because this will cut the mycelium and will hurt the spawn. The substrate, the best substrate was again fermented and sterilized compost was ideal and gave superior growth. Other organic material from the forest was not so suitable. Promising wild mushrooms, we chose the salt mushroom, Agaricus bernardi, it has a large size, Tenderman mushroom, Bionotus erangi, and Jarash mushroom, Trichloma terium. Salt and Tenderman mushroom until now require fermented and pasteurized compost for ideal growth, but using wheat straw takes a longer time and gave lower yield. The Jarash mushroom, Trichloma, can be grown directly near the pine tree roots in winter without any substrate, but it gave only one fruit or sorry, in one season in a short time. We must use autoclaved media, PDA, to isolate the culture in clean conditions. We produced the primary liquorum, the primary spawn in petri dishes on a garden on different seeds, and again the best was wheat. Here mixing the substrate with the spawn, and here we recommend the small or the mini box to grow mushrooms because it has a benefit to be humid enough for the mushroom growth, even if it is small. So we make holes in all sides of this box, but we should add a perlite as a humidifier in the at the bottom of the box. There are many boxes to grow mushrooms. Footing stages are coming, and our spawn is commercially produced by Murtaza Basha Association or lab. There is the Trichloma. Again, the spawn running in the incubator. And this is the lower surface of the RBJ mushroom, the Rengi. Again, this is the upper surface. And here we try to produce them in glass jars according to the recommendation of Prince Basma Abd Ali, he didn't like to produce them in polyethylene bags. Mushroom production, fold developed fruits. Here we are trying to teach the local community on mushroom production by using the simple techniques, the low cost techniques. And here we enucleate the different facilities by using the cylindrical sacks as the narrow sacks. Thank you.